Hey, you. Yeah, you. Want to be the freshest squid on the block? We'll teach you some funky fresh moves on the way to Inkopolis. Shoot ink with ZR, pop the balloon. Yeah, we get to pop balloons with motion control. If only Diddy Kong Racing DS had that, then maybe popping balloons would have actually been fun. Hello, I'm Galactic Sweet, and welcome to my brand new Let's Play of Splatoon. We're here in the... Oh, jeez. Normally I have the camera sensitivity a little different, so it feels a bit odd. I'm Galactic Sweet. Welcome to my brand new Let's Play of Splatoon. I hope you are looking forward to this as much as I'm looking forward to making it, because I am looking forward a lot to it. This is the tutorial area, and getting right on praising this game. I love this area so much. It's just so unique and, well, not unique. That's not the right word. But it, like, if you just want to run around and figure out the controls of Splatoon, it's there. This is here for you. You can just take your time. There's no rush. And I think this is a great tutorial area. It was easily the best way they could have done tutorials for Splatoon. So, yeah, this is my Let's Play of Splatoon. What you can expect from this Let's Play, you can expect all single player, and I want to go over every multiplayer weapon. You can imagine this one's going to go on for a while. So, oh yes, this part coming up. I do want to talk about this because I always thought this was interesting. You can see there's like this UFO thing here. The very first time I ever played this game, I got up here and then I fell off immediately, yes. So I got up. I said I got up here. Jeez, do I have to do it from the other side? And I said, everything that my ink touches is my land. Which is actually kind of pitiful if that's all my land really is. Let's change that a little. Yes, the whole idea of Splatoon is to cover your own turf. Mark your turf. Not the way dogs do it, but with ink. It still sounds pretty bad. You can see there's just a bunch of little stuff here. If you were messing around in the previous area, you could see that there were trees that you couldn't really ink. They're the squid's natural enemy. And with that, just straight ahead is our way to Inkopolis. We could throw bombs with R. We can turn into a squid using ZL on the Wii U gamepad. And we can even shoot with ZR. Yeah, I probably should have been going over the controls for a bit now. Bombs do take up a bit of ink, as you see there. But if just hiding in your ink will refill your ink. So, like, say you use all your ink and... ta-da, you're out of ink. If you just stand still, it'll naturally refill. If you want to refill faster, go into ink. And if you want to refill even faster than that, move around in ink. Because as your tank will refill even faster. And I just noticed there was a Callie and Marie poster there. And I covered them in ink. Oddly inappropriate internet reference here. So without further ado, rather, let's head off to Inkopolis. Hold on to your tentacles! It's Inkopolis news time. Let's unveil the current regular battle stages. Alright! The food court makes the best catfish burgers ever! I'm more of a hot dog fish girl myself. My friend has the best view from her place here! Give me a kitchen over a nice view any day. And now, the current rank battle stages. Splatastic. What are they studying in the kelp dome anyway? Algebra. The soothing sea backdrop makes me want to nap. Everything makes me want to nap. Murray understands me. Newsflash, newsflash! What is it? What is it? Inkopolis' Great Zapfish has Vanished? What? Seriously? If it isn't recovered soon, are we gonna lose power? Oh, I'm sure it'll be fine. Probably. I wonder if it has anything to do with that UFO crash. Sounds likely to me. Or could you say it sounds fishy? Well, until next time, stay fresh! Welcome to Inkopolis. This is the plaza where all the freshest folk come to chill like krill. Most Inklings here are obsessed with the hottest sport in Inkopolis, Ink Battles. That crazy tall building in front of you is Inkopolis Tower. It's the city's most famous landmark. There's a lobby on the first floor of Inkopolis Tower for online battles. This is Booyah Base, a shopping mall for all your Inkling needs. You can buy all kinds of fresh gear and weapons to use in battle. But check it, the staff in the shops can be a snobby bunch. They won't serve you if they don't think you're fresh enough. The Battle Dojo is on the second floor of that building over there, not even given a name. Check it out if you want to battle your friends one-on-one and sharpen your skills. You might want to steer clear of that back alley. Smells a little fishy. Yeah, I already made that pun. Yeah, beat you to it, game. And next we have... Huh? What's that creepy old dude? Or who's that with him? I can't read. He seems like the type who could get you mixed up in something dangerous. Whatever, why don't you just head over to the lobby in Inkopolis Tower? That's where you can get your splat on. So yes, welcome to Splatoon, a game released for the Wii U in 2014? No, 2015, because it was released shortly after I graduated high school. Right, I knew that. I was just testing you guys. Yeah, I graduated high school in 2015. There you go, now you know a little something about me. But this guy says that we were told we could get mixed up in something dangerous here. And I happen to be a fan of adventure, so why don't we see what's in store for us. The Octarians are coming! No! Oh, hi. I guess I lost my cool there for a minute. I'm Captain Cuttlefish, leader of the legendary Squidbeak Splatoon. That look in your eye, it's the look I've been looking for. The great Zapfish that powers Inkopolis has been squidnapped. Nobody believes me, but it's the work of the Octarians, I just know it! They want revenge for the great turf war of 100 years ago. I've been keeping an eye on them this whole time, of course. Wow, for 100 years? I don't know what to say. You've literally been doing nothing for 100 years, but keeping an eye on people you defeated in a war. Okay. But they stole the great Zapfish right out from under my nose! Well, not from under your nose, but from the Inkopolis Tower. I'd be very worried if it could fit under your nose. But hey, who am I to judge? Please, you've got to help me rescue the great Zapfish. So, I'm going to take your silence as a yes? Hey, I never said yes, but I never said no either. Starting today, you are Agent 3 of the new Squidbeak Splatoon. This is your brand new hero suit. It'll help you fight the Octarians. What a great fit for a hand-me-down from Agents 1 and 2. Now let's get those oxygens. I'm counting on you, Buckle. What was that about Agent 1 and 2? Why don't they have this uniform anymore? Is there something you're not telling me? I'll cover you in my ink. God, the innuendos are just way too strong today. So yes, this is Splatoon single player. I find it kind of interesting that they have it sort of tucked away in just this odd off part of the plaza. Because while the main focus of Splatoon is its multiplayer, its single player is pretty good. Not the most amazing single player game you'll ever play, but it's pretty good. It's definitely, if you've never played Splatoon before, playing Splatoon single player will probably just make you say, wow. It's really inventive and unique, and I really like it for that. The entire concept of Splatoon in general is great. At least I don't know anything else that has tried it. But hey. So, with that, you can see there's kind of a transparent thing here. I don't know what else to call it. Energy squirt with ink. It creates a tea kettle. And we can go to the tea kettle by pressing ZL. We turn into a squid, and this is an important lesson that squids can go through grades. But welcome to the first level of the game, Octo Trooper Hideout. Yeah, that's right, we're not taking it easy, we're going straight into their hideout, the very first level. So, yes, the controls that I mentioned before apply here, except your gun's a bit longer range now, which is nice. For those of you wondering, this is actually the same as the normal splatter shot, but we'll get that when we get to the multiplayer. And I guess I should also talk about what you can expect from this Let's Play. This will be showing all of the single player, all collectibles, everything. And we're going to be showing the multiplayer as well. Originally, I was only planning on doing the single player, but also watching someone do another series on this. Playing around with the idea more of a Splatoon Let's Play makes me realize that I really should cover the multiplayer, because the multiplayer is what makes this great game so great. The single player is good, don't get me wrong, but the multiplayer is where all countless hours of joy and fun have come from in this game. Well, not all of them, obviously, the single player is good. So yes, to digress really quickly, we have an enemy here. I've sort of just been carelessly murdering enemies, but you're supposed to keep going around him until he doesn't notice you, and then get from him from behind. I didn't realize you're ever supposed to do that. Captain Cuttlefish telling you to do that. Instead, I just did this. If you throw a bomb, he'll face towards it to protect himself, or herself, or itself. I don't know what gender Octarians are. And you can use that to expose their backside. Yeah. So as I was saying, this Let's Play will be covering all aspects of Splatoon. Whatever I can. And I also wanted to make this Let's Play extra special. And now it's time to completely outdate this video by mentioning this small little tidbit. As of the time of recording this video, Splatoon 2 has not been released. It's been announced, it's been show off. In fact, the Nintendo Switch itself is going to be released in a few days, so yeah. And I want this Let's Play to be a kind of, not a love letter, but a sort of final send-off to the original Splatoon before Splatoon 2 comes out. Because this game, despite its flaws, have brought so much countless hours of fun to myself and so many other people who enjoyed this game. And if you're like me, I hope you really enjoy this Let's Play. I'll be going every single weapon. That's right, every single weapon. Speaking of which, I said I was watching another Let's Player do this game, that's where I kind of got the idea to do some of this stuff. He was also the person who tried to get the Octarian by doing this. Are you serious? I was going to say the best way to do it is to throw a bomb up there and then shoot him from behind like that. But I managed to do that just by shooting a few stray bullets. Okay, you know, I'm not going to complain. With that, let's go onward. Another little experience from my first time playing this game. I didn't realize you could jump down here. You can totally go over here and take out these guys, but I thought you had to take them out from over here. And the portal, the jump portal, whatever. It's kind of like a launch star from Mario Galaxy. This game does have kind of Mario Galaxy-esque design. In that you go from like little mini world to little mini world of just whatever. And I think the single player does a great job of teaching controls. Alright, where was I? Yes, I said I wanted to make this Let's Play as a final send-off to the original Splatoon. Because when Splatoon 2 comes out, everyone's going to be all over the brand new Splatoon 2, and I will be too. But I want to take this time to remember what made the original so great, why I fell in love with the game, why I'm sure many of you fell in love with the game. And if you've never played Splatoon before or didn't care for it, I hope you give it another chance. It's that game that everyone who plays it loves, at least most people do, but outside of that, everyone I've talked to who hasn't played it's like, oh yeah, I heard it was that cool new shooter from Nintendo. It's a shame I don't have a Wii U, and I'm not going to play it. Or the other common response I've heard is, wow, how do you keep track of everything with all these colors? God, it's so vivid, and I couldn't keep track of anything. I never found it that tough to keep track of stuff, and I'm colorblind. Well, colorblind's a bit misleading. I have a color seeing deficiency. Colorblind implies I can't see a specific color. I have trouble differentiating colors that are really close to each other. So I guess the best way to describe it would be the colors I see are a little less vivid than the colors you see. And dang, the colors I see are also pretty vivid, so I can't even imagine. I literally can't even imagine how vivid they'd be if I could see colors in a full proper spectrum. But hey, enough about that. We got a key, and we're gonna do everyone's favorite Legend of Zelda puzzle. Take a key to the lock. And we've arrived here in the final area, the final checkpoint. And we can see that there are enemies coming around here. You can see there's one that's moving with the shield. So you either need to go around like this, which is honestly more fun than just tossing a bomb with using R and then pressing it. And you can break the blocks like so. And yes, I should probably mention, if you walk in enemy ink, or ink that isn't your own color rather, you will take damage, and you'll move at the pace of a snail, but it won't kill you. But you will be set up for like a one shot to be killed in one shot. You take damage, just can't kill you. Yes, that's right. You thought you could run away from my bomb. You can see there's another Octarian here with two tentacles on his head. You can see he shoots out a much more rapid spray of ink. I've died to that guy before. Yeah, that's right. I've died on the first level of this game. Because I am If playing Mario 64 DS has taught me anything, it's that I am absolutely terrible at video games. But without further ado, let's jump up here. What you're supposed to do is you're supposed to keep attacking that. And if you don't get it in a certain time, the shield will reform. However, if you're just impatient like me, just throw a bomb. It always pops the shield in one go. So yeah, that is Splatoon. Well, obviously this is one level in all of Splatoon. We've already been going for quite some time and Actually, we'll do one more. Wait. Right, every stage has something called a sunken sea scroll. You saw me get it when I climbed up that large pillar in one of the areas. It basically gives you a little background on Splatoon lore. Since time immemorial, a rare type of electric catfish known as the Zapfish has been prized by Inkling society as a source of energy. In fact, the entire city of Inkopolis is powered by a single 100-year-old Great Zapfish. And if we hide the research notes, you can see some nice little artwork. Dang, these creatures' sole existence is to power the technology. And we're supposed to be the good guys, right? So, the idea of finding levels, which I always thought was really cool, is that you have to reveal them. You can tell where they are, like you can see there's this sort of transparent thing I'm standing on, and you shoot it, and it reveals a level. And that's how you find all the levels. And then there's this giant kettle, but it says you need more Zapfish. So we can't exactly do anything with that yet. But let's head on to the second level. Lair of the Octoballs. Splat your way to the top. And by splash your way to the top, we immediately have an incline downward. But hey, we're going up immediately afterwards, so I guess they're not wrong. And I guess I should also mention, these little orbs are getting, they're called Zapfish Eggs, I believe. They're kind of like coins in the Mario game, except they have a bit more of a purpose, which we will be seeing. Yes, so that special balloon, when you hit it with any form of ink, it blows up and it becomes an insta-kill for anything nearby, essentially. Nothing like that really in the multiplayer, but it's there in the single player to get rid of a group of enemies. I never liked this thing's face, if you just saw it a few seconds ago. Yeah, that's such a horrible thing to say. These enemies, I don't know their name, but they are explodey missile things. They'll charge at you and suicide bomb into you. Hooray! And you can see we have another balloon. If we shoot it, it makes the entire wall covered in ink. Normally you can just climb up walls by just holding forward, but if you want to climb faster, start tapping the X button. The X button in this game lets you jump. I believe it's a B button in Splatoon 2. The B button doesn't actually do anything in this game. The X button opens a mini map in Splatoon 2, but hey. So yeah, as I was saying, I want this Let's Play to be a sort of final send-off for Splatoon, because this game is amazing. So, what better way to talk about how great this game is than focus on the amazing level design? it's not super tough. It's not super challenging. It's not like, oh, wow, that was so tough and it was... But it's a unique experience. You can't get anywhere else. And here we have new enemies called Octoballs. They run into you and that's about it. Oh, shoot! That didn't happen, I swear. Yes, they can run you over. That is like the first time I've ever died to an Octoball. Wow. And it's only on the first episode, second level. You could tell this is going to be a great Let's Play, guys. Only the most skilled gameplay here at Galactic Suites YouTube Let's Plays. This Sunken Scroll. This one was one of the toughest Sunken Scrolls because I could just not find it wherever. I completely passed over. But yes, you have to drop through. Look down and drop through. It's just really creative stuff like this that Splatoon's just really memorable for. That's a Sunken Scroll that once you find it, you never forget because it threw you off the first time on how to find it. Unless this is like your first time ever seeing this level, and then maybe you'll remember, maybe you won't. And I love the little squid face and noise they make when they hit something while climbing. I'll just let you listen to it for a second. It's just like, boing, boing. I don't know. It's more adorable than that. I can't make adorable noises. But we can see there is a, well, our launch star equivalent super jump pad on the wall there. And it brings us to this next area. I never really bothered to look around and take a good look at the environment, but you can see some pretty interesting stuff. There's like a twisted highway. It's like a highway to hell? I don't know. We got random floating chunks of building can attach to another random floating chunk of building. And we have what looks like the sky out there. But if you look closely, you sort of see panels. Yeah, we're underground. You can see like the lights here is what's actually producing the light. You can see rocks up there. Yeah, we're totally underground right now. It just sort of looks like we aren't underground. I like the theories that state that this is essentially the Octarians' underground society, and that they need power for their society, but we decided to raid it. I was just shooting right here, and this just filled up, and I wasn't even shooting at it. What? That's so weird. Oh well, back to the actual level itself. And see, we got more Octoballs. And we have a suitcase. By my beard, it's armor! And we have these things. These things. Their goal is to clean up ink. I bet Mario wish he had one of these when he went to Delfino. But it's a common thing is that you'll shoot your own ink and then they'll start to clean it up. It can make climbing walls kind of annoying is when they're on a wall. We have this volcano-like structure. I always thought it looked like a volcano at least. And with that, we can shoot this. And ta-da, it paints the wall for us. And this one just has a fish egg on top of it for whatever reason. But hey, the other one had armor on top of it. The armor essentially gives you an extra life. If I get hit with something that was supposed to splat me, not kill me, because you can't die in this universe, you can only be splatted, even though it's essentially the same thing. I would essentially get a freebie, and because I have this armor. I always like the fact that you can just sort of go through the railings as a squid. But you can't go through them as a person, so you just sort of stand on them. And then, no, I fell! I knew that's what... I almost made that back. Well, we're going to fast forward until I get back there really quick. Speed running strats! You got nothing on me! Nothing! Oh, wait, I want this box. I guess I said I was going to speed up, but hey. Also, you see there's like a little gap here. The ink isn't perfect. Sometimes there are points where you can't get through it, but if you just jump, you should be able to make it. And of course, there's other times where you just can't make a gap in the wall. Say like this one, you can't. Well, you can because you see the more I jump, the more it started to push ink upwards. So eventually I'd be able to make it, but it'd be faster to just drop down, shoot, and then get it up. And here we have a checkpoint. So you see in the top left, we have three bars. That's essentially our lives. When that hits zero, it's game over. We're kicked out of the level. But don't worry, all you'll lose is whatever progress you've made on this level. And for every checkpoint, you'll get a life back. Yeah, they're very generous in this game. If you're new to Splatoon, not sure how to play it, I definitely recommend the single player of the original Wii U Splatoon. That's it! Heave-ho! So, just to let you know, it's possible to do this part just by literally doing this. And yes, we got our little cleaning friend who reminds me of a robot from Wall-E right here. But what we really want to do is we want to take this pad, have our final checkpoint, and we have a bazooka or ink cannon. We can literally just launch ink missiles and destroy everyone in our path. Or shoot balloons. Take that, Diddy Kong Racing. We did shooting balloons better than you. But, yeah. You essentially want to just ink this area. You can pop the Zapfish, though, the shield, but it'll probably reform by the time you get up there. And we can only aim so far down. But with that, we can just jump off. And if you're having trouble with this, what I recommend doing is shooting like this and then sort of going around in a U. So it doesn't clean ink that fast, so you definitely have time. It's easier to climb if you're looking up. Try tilting whatever that is. I'd like to imagine they have no idea what a gamepad is and Splatoon. But with that, we made it to the top. We'll blow up the shield really fast with the bomb because we're impatient and claim our Zapfish. They're adorable. I love a Zapfish plushie. Well, speaking of Zapfish plushie, just one little thing I'd love to... Oh, before we start with it. We Octarians dwell in a world deep underground. These individual caves... These individual caves on which we live are connected by a network of transportation devices known as cattles. Wow, you learn something new every day. Oh, that hurt my voice to do. Yes, so as I was just explaining, it looks like we're above ground, but we're really just an underground environment. Called Kettle. And the transportation there is called Kettles. I think we're going to call it there for an episode really quick, but I just want to show one more thing. One, on the gamepad, or two more things, I guess. On the gamepad, any level you've accessed or unlocked can be jumped to simply by tapping to it. If you're not sure what level it is, if you hold down on the gamepad, you'll see the number of the level. So if you want to go to level 1, you can just drag your finger or stylus across the touch screen and just see what number the level is. And I don't remember if there's a specific way to tell whether you've already completed it or not, but you can do it to levels you haven't revealed yet. So yeah, so there's something I just want to show really quick at the end of this level. We're probably just going to fast forward. Maybe I can show you what it's like to do this level a little bit faster. I'm no speedrunner at this game, but I am experienced in Splatoon multiplayer, so that's something going for me, right? That's good, right? Let's see. Get you, and I never seen him fall down there before. Interesting. Right, so I'll meet you guys at the end of the level. So you can see that the Zapfish here is not the actual Zapfish, but rather a stuffed version with a hat. I think that's absolutely adorable. And absolutely hilarious that that's a thing. I don't know why, but it's really funny. So with that, I think that's enough to call it an episode here. Thank you so much for watching, and on next episode of Splatoon, we can see that there's a new level opened up for us. And we'll go check it out, what it is. Well, I already said it, but I'll say it again. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, well, shameless subscribe plug because I need subscribers. But hey, doesn't everyone? It's a cruel, tough world. Until next time.